Greetings from Bengaluru. My name is Prasad and I'm a retired professor of organizational behavior at the Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore. Along with my co-author, Mr. S. Ramachandran, a principal consultant at Infosys, we have co-authored a book on Neoskilling. Neoskilling involves inculcating a higher order of thinking, so we are creative and innovative in ways that no machine can replace us, however intelligent it may be.
If we look at the continuum of skill development initiatives happening in corporates today, neoskilling is up there. Upskilling is incremental improvements in skill sets. Reskilling involves lateral movements to new areas, but neoskilling is much more holistic. It is futuristic in preparation for skills and roles, some of which may not even be clear today. Neoskilling is very vital for business growth, but that cannot be at the cost of the basics of running a business with integrity. This is what we call the MINIMEC trap. MINIMEC is an acronym which stands for a situation of strategically myopic, intellectually impoverished, ethically challenged and obtuse management. Neoskilling is not just limited to classroom training. It has both hard skills and soft skills. We look at the hierarchy of neoskilling in 5 stages. An interesting finding that we found in the study was that the biggest challenge organizations face is in the awareness phase itself, in knowing on which skill sets the employees have to be trained.
Neoskilling necessitates that individuals undergo a mental metamorphosis to appreciate and internalize the importance of working synergistically in teams. In a complex, volatile world, teamwork is essential to ensure organizational agility. Individual stars have to learn to work together in groups where expert power and the ability to influence others is more important than one's position in the hierarchy, seniority based on years of experience, etc. This is where Perrow's classification of technology comes in handy. The secret behind neoskilling is not being reactive while trying to stay one step ahead of automation bots and AI systems, but to be proactive. Jobs that fall in the routine category, high programmability and low variety, will be automated. Professional jobs, which are high in programmability and high in variety, will soon be done by AI systems. Therefore, individuals whose occupations fall in these two categories will have to neo-skill themselves for craft jobs, which are low in programmability and low in variety, or non-routine jobs, which are low in programmability and high in variety. Inter-organizational initiatives experience the synergy of virtuous circles, while permanently failing initiatives will spiral into vicious circles from which it may be difficult, if not impossible, to recover.
So here is a blueprint for implementing neoskilling. It starts with a cultural transformation. Everybody in the organization should start believing in lifelong learning. Neoskilling is not limited only to corporates. It can also help in inclusive growth for all sections of the society. It starts from basic information sharing to the bottom of the pyramid. It provides a social identity for people. It provides financial inclusion in the form of bank accounts. It also eventually provides education and empowerment for people to carry out a self-sustained living. To summarize, this table shows the key aspects of neoskilling when compared to regular reskilling. Neoskilling is proactive. It is driven by leaders, decision makers, and senior management, but with the cooperation of everybody in the organization.